Meghan looks relaxed as she steps out with Harry to unveil a statue after spending the night at a lavish five-star Fijian resort following her security scare at an overcrowded market. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have unveiled a statue to a hero sergeant in Fiji after spending the night at a lavish five-star resort on one of the country's private islands. Prince Harry and wife Meghan Markle flew in from the capital Suvetonadi, in the country's west, for the unveiling, as they continue their marathon 16-day royal tour. The couple had spent last night on the paradise isle of Vaitavara together as they took a break from their jam-packed schedule. Security are holding back crowds which have turned out to catch a glimpse of the pair in Nadi, after a security scare cut short Meghan's visit to the overcrowded Suva market a day earlier. The royals were given a traditional welcome on arrival in Nadi after stepping off their chartered flight on their last morning in Fiji before flying on to Tonga. The new statue commemorates Sergeant Talaiasi Labalaba, a British Fijian soldier who died heroically in battle. Sergeant Talaiasi Labalaba, a Fijian member of the elite British Special Air Service, SAS, single-handedly held off 250 attackers from taking an army base 46 years ago. Labalaba, renowned as one of the SAS's greatest heroes, gave his life in an epic struggle to defend his fellow soldiers at the Battle of Murbat, in what is now Yemen, in 1972. Labalaba and eight fellow SAS soldiers were stationed at a British Army training team house just outside the port of Murbat in Oman. For a year the crack unit had been on a secret assignment, codenamed Operation Jaguar, to protect the Sultan of Oman from an insurgent force, the People's Front for the Liberation of the Occupied Arab Gulf. On the morning of July 19, 1972, 250 of the front's best fighters stormed the port in a surprise attack that left the nine SAS men pinned down inside their fort. Labalaba, 30, knew that without heavier firepower, the unit faced almost certain annihilation. In a daring break, he sprinted across an exposed 800-yard stretch to reach a 25-pound field gun. The gun usually required three men to operate it, and by the time he reached it Labalaba was soaked in blood from a bullet wound to his jaw. But the elite soldier, still under heavy fire, spun the cumbersome weapon to face the advancing guerrilla fighters and opened up from close range, decimating them. Ignoring his wounds he continued to hold off the 250 front fighters for 6 hours. Captain Mike Keeley and comrades Tommy Tobin and Sukuna Atikevezai also ran the 800-yard gauntlet to try to save the courageous sergeant's life. They arrived too late, but Labalaba had held off the guerrilla force long enough for the Sultan's strike master jets to arrive. The jets drove back the attackers while reinforcements from nearby Salalah were organized. In SAS Operation Storm, a book recounting the battle, fellow trooper Roger Cole wrote that the fight would surely have been lost had Labalaba not taken the 25-pounder. The sergeant was posthumously awarded a mention in dispatches for his bravery, and his body was returned to England, where it was buried at St. Martin's Church in Hereford. A statue to the war hero was erected at the SAS headquarters outside the town in 2009. Labalaba is an enduring legend among Fijians, 1,250 of whom are currently serving in the British Army. The soldier's son, Iai Adair Labalaba, 53, was at the ceremony and spoke of his pride that Prince Harry would be unveiling his father's statue. "I'm so excited, so happy today. I last saw him in 1971 when he left for his tour of duty. He was meant to come home again within days when he died. I was just 4 years and 11 months old," he said. "He was a really family man, my father. I am very excited to meet Prince Harry. It is a great honor that he has agreed to do this." His comrade Sukuna Atikevezai Vokolo, 75, was with Labalaba when he died and was himself shot in the shoulder by a bullet that just missed his head. "We were blood brothers, we stood side by side. It was the last day of our five-month tour. We had some rum to celebrate the night before and had packed our belongings and gone to sleep before the handover. It was 4 a.m. when the attack started. We thought it would be just another skirmish and they would hear back into the mountains. But it wasn't and we were outnumbered." He added how "we have campaigned for a long time for a statue to commemorate him. It is wonderful to have a memorial to him here in Fiji. It is very important to the Fijian people," he said. We were very proud to serve the crown, so it means a lot to us to have Prince Harry here to unveil it. His brother Prince William unveiled a statue on Hereford in 2014. Tourism Minister Fayez Koya said of Harry and Meghan's trip to Fiji, "We are proud to host them. This is a worldwide event, so it is tremendous for us. They are a couple with global appeal to everyone." He confirmed that the newlyweds, who are expecting their first child in April, spent last night on the paradise isle of Vaitavara together. This private island boasts it offers conscientious luxury to the discerning traveler and is one of the world's most beautiful places. It has three secluded and expansive seaside villas, meticulously crafted with natural textures and materials, creating spacious and comfortably elegant environments. Vaitavara is one of those islands you will not forget. It showcases the Fijian spirit and what we have as Fijian people. It's absolutely beautiful, stunning. They would have enjoyed themselves, Mr. Koya said. After the ceremony, the couple boarded their Qantas charter flight for the South Pacific nation of Tonga, the third country they are visiting during their 16-day trip on behalf of the Queen. There they will receive an official welcome to the country from Her Royal Highness the Princess Angelica Latiafupka at the airport. Later they will be the guests of honor at another welcome reception and dinner in Nuku'alofa with the Tongan ruler, King Tupu VI, and his wife, Queen Nanasapuu, with traditional Tongan entertainment.